We have updated coronavirus numbers for you now. The Louisiana Department of Health just released these just a short time ago. As of right now, there are 1,388 cases in Louisiana and 46 deaths. 43 parishes are now reporting at least one case of coronavirus. Again, the governor will be holding a press conference this afternoon at 2:30, and we'll probably get more information then. The need to find families in our area, to feed families in our area, has grown dramatically ever since the coronavirus. Today, the Louisiana National Guard is helping the Second Harvest Food Bank give out meals. Duke Carter is live at Second Harvest, and Duke, this is very good news for the food bank.
You're exactly right, Eric. This is good news for the food bank because the food bank put out a call to the National Guard yesterday, and then this morning, 20 servicemen and women are still trying to help any way they can with any way that's needed here at the food bank. Take a look at this video here. So the National Guard, they arrived here at Second Harvest Food Bank a little bit after 7:45 this morning. They got a tour of the facility. And then began working. Some were helping package food and others were in the kitchen helping workers prepare the food that will then be distributed to partnering agencies. So workers and leaders at Second Harvest say having a National Guard here is helpful.
Having the National Guard here it's actually pretty great for us to have them here. We have so many requests being made to Second Harvest Food Bank, and knowing that they're here to support us in the fight that we're in right now really allows us to kind of take just a breather, knowing that there's help.
Some have driver's licenses for commercial vehicles, so we can give our drivers a break and handle more deliveries. And then they could help us with all of our partners in communities as we distribute these food boxes to gig industry, service industry workers.
So while the National Guard is here, leaders are saying the biggest challenge now is, of course, getting food to help those partnering agencies. So if you can donate, donate at Second Harvest Food Bank here in Elwood. For now, reporting live, Duke Carter, Eyewitness News.
All right, Duke, thank you very much. At the same time, options for grab-and-go meals shrunk a bit. St. Tammany Parish Public Schools have suspended their meal program. The superintendent there, Troy Foles, says, quote, "We know this is an important service for our families in need at this time, but the safety and health of our students, employees, and the community remain our top priority." The school system is now looking for other ways to get food to students there. Meals are available around the rest of Southeast Louisiana. Here in New Orleans, your children do not have to be with you in order to receive a meal. If you want to see all the locations, we have them all on our app, our mobile app, and our website, WWLTV.com. Remember, if you think you have the symptoms of the coronavirus, like a cough, fever, and shortness of breath, you can get tested. There are three drive-through testing sites. Two of those are still open for the day. They're located at the Mahalia Jackson Theater and the Lakefront Arena. The test site at the Ilario Center in Westwego has already hit its 250 test allotment, so it is closed for the day. If you're not feeling well, though, and you're not sure if you have the symptoms of the coronavirus, you can also call any of these three numbers. You'll be connected to a nurse who will help you go over the symptoms and guide you where you should go from there, but they're recommending just don't go to the hospital. The Louisiana Department of Revenue has joined the federal government in extending the income tax deadline. State taxes are now due by July 15th. They're originally due in May. Just last week, the U.S. Treasury decided to extend the federal income tax deadline to July 15th as well. And the stock market's having a really good day today after the White House and Congress both say they're close to a deal to pump more than $1 trillion into the economy. Natalie Brand has that story from the White House.
President Trump is urging Congress to act today on an economic stimulus package, tweeting, "The longer it takes, the harder it will be to start up our economy." The president is also now reconsidering whether national social distancing guidelines are needed when the original 15-day period ends.
We can't have the cure be worse than the problem.
But some medical experts are pushing back. President Trump's former FDA commissioner tweeted, "There's no such thing as a functioning economy and society so long as COVID-19 continues to spread uncontrolled in our biggest cities." The president says coronavirus hotspots such as New York and California will likely continue to see more stringent policies in place.
There are other areas that just aren't affected or they're affected very little. And why would we close down 100% of the country?
The White House economic team says negotiations with Senate Democrats are down to a small number of issues, and they're hopeful to finalize a bipartisan stimulus package today.
If we can get this package, we'll be setting the stage for a good rebound in the second half of the year.
Senate Democrats say they've made progress in putting in more accountability on big businesses receiving part of the funding. Democrats also pushed for additional financial help for hospitals overwhelmed with coronavirus patients. Natalie Brand, CBS News, The White House.
And here's a live look at Wall Street right now. The Dow is up more than 1,500 points. At one time, it was up over 1,800. Wall Street is kind of optimistic that that measure will get past the Senate if it does vote on that today. Trials and treatments for treatments and vaccines have started all across the country. A trial led by the University of Minnesota began. Researchers there are testing two low-cost generic drugs that can be used to help treat the virus, they hope. The first is a drug used to fight malaria. Doctors say the drug has an antiviral effect. It suppresses the production and release of proteins involved in complications of viral diseases. The same drug is also being tested in China, Australia, and France. The other drug that's being tested is losartan. It's normally prescribed as a blood pressure medication, but doctors say it could help block an enzyme used by the virus to bind cells to your body. Although these trials seem promising, researchers say a vaccine could still take a year or more before it becomes available to the public.